Hi there, I'm Josh, and today we're going to get you started with ZEISS Reverse Engineering. In this Getting Started video, we'll be showing you how to edit and align your mesh in ZEISS Reverse Engineering. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead, so let's get started. Notice the mesh of this small statue has some things we need to take care of. Here are some extra scan data we need to remove. Let's use the Remove Islands from Mesh tool to do this. The default setting for the minimum number of triangles is sufficient. Next, let's give this part a more appropriate alignment. Under the Alignment category, we find Best Fit via Three Planes. Now we can easily view our statue in an intuitive manner and use the coordinate cube to set a good view. Sometimes it could be that there are still some small holes in your scan data. In ZEISS Reverse Engineering, we are able to close these holes. By using the function Fill Holes in Mesh Automatically, we can set a value for the hole size, 50 millimeters is good here, select Curve, and execute and close. Now that we have a fully closed and aligned mesh without any unwanted data, we are ready to start the reverse engineering process. For this part, we use the function Automatic Mesh-Based Surface Creation to create this CAD model. We've now shown you how to prepare your mesh data for reverse engineering using some of the mesh editing features in ZEISS Reverse Engineering. If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, or if you have any issues with ZEISS Reverse Engineering, please reach out to us via support@handsonmetrology.com. For more Getting Started information, please check out our other videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.